Without further ado, I would like to invite these two gentlemen to the stage, Mr. Milton and Mr. Dodd, because they are going to pour into you with a song with their amazing voices. Gentlemen, would you please come to the stage? Hallelujah.
On the inside, yeah, that I can't keep to myself. I holler, staring up from the depth of my soul. So excuse me if I seem a little giddy or maybe even strange, 'cause praise every one of you. No, we have enjoyed the testimonies. Nobody but Jesus. Nobody but Jesus. We have our businesses. We have desire to have a business. We have these goals. Your sister just told you about all that she went through. She didn't know the road that she would have to travel. This is a man who spoke to know the word of God. But the Bible says this, put no trust in man. No trust in man. No means no trust in man. But put your trust in God. Because he's the one that can see you through. I couldn't help myself because I got Jesus on the inside. It's like Jeremiah says, it's like fire shut up in my bones. I can't help myself. I don't make no excuse for it. This praise is on the inside. And I tell it wherever I go. Because you got to be bold for Jesus.
Yes.
You can't be scared. Yes. Just like you did when you was in the world doing the wrong thing.
Yes.
You got to be just that bold for Jesus. And let folks know, for God I live and for God I live.
Yes.
He's a good God. He's a great God. He can do anything but fail. But you must have faith. You must trust him. Because without faith it's impossible to please him. Brother Mel, you got something else to say?
I do. Thank you, Brother Don. I'm so glad to be invited here today. When Angela, my co-worker, asked, could I come? I hesitated at first because I was still dealing with a lot of nervous energy and things of that nature. I'm a recovering alcoholic and a drug addict. I've been clean and sober for 12 years. God has forgiven me. I stepped out of Martinsburg, West Virginia. I'm a Vietnam veteran. Went to Martinsburg, West Virginia. I was always in the computer field, IT field, and stuff like that. I got caught up. I'm from Washington, D.C. also. And I turned 70 on my birthday. And I just thank God so much for delivering me. I was going to AA meetings, NA meetings, and everything. And oh, it was so beneficial to me. But until I turned it over to God.
Yeah.
So I turned it over to God,
then
he began to really work in my life. I walked into Reed Temple AME Church in Danville, Maryland, and I went to join the men's choir, and I ran to my little brother here. I called him my little brother, he called him his big brother. God sent him to put him in my life. He's been there for me ever since. 2 years ago, I had prostate cancer. God has blessed me. I have no more cancer. I'm a cancer survivor. I also, of course, have hepatitis C, and that has been erased. I got my military benefits, and I was able to take this miracle cure that really just took all that away from me. So I'm so much to be thankful for. I got my family back. My family trusts me again. My kids look up to me on my way over here today. They said, Dad, we are so proud that you're doing this thing. And these kids were not in my life because I was out there in them doggone streets.
Yeah, yeah.
But I got my life back, and only I give it on through the grace of God.
Yeah.
Because